गुड आफ्टरनून। सब्जेक्ट CS 451, सब्जेक्ट कोड, कोर्स टाइटल कंपाइलर डिजाइन एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द LALR पार्सिंग इन द चैप्टर ऑफ सिंटैक्स एनालिसिस। दी आर द टेक्स्ट एंड रेफरेंस बुक्स course review in the syntax analysis. We in the last class we have discussed about the LR parsing properties and structure of LR parsing, type of LR parser, these are the types, SLR, construction of parsing table, closure and go to operations. Then the next parser, that is the canonical LR parser and construction of parsing table. Now today we will discuss about the LALR parser, that is the third parser. So we have the context free grammar like the SLR or CLR. We will construct the canonical set of items along with the look ahead, and then we will construct the LALR parsing table. Then we will take the input strings. If the input string it belongs to this grammar, then the parser will accept the string. If the string is not belongs to that grammar, then it will give the error. See the procedure. So here first is construction of the canonical set of items with the look ahead. How can we construct the canonical set of items? The procedure is same as the construction of the canonical item in LR parsing, or you can say CLR parsing. So here the construction of LR1 items is the same as in CLR, canonical LR parsing. The difference is that LR1 items for LR parser, we have deferred the two states if the second component is different, but in LAR we will merge the two states by merging of first and second component from the both the states. See the same example. First, see how can we construct the LALR parsing table. First, construction of LR1 set of items like the CLR. Then we will, in the LALR parsing, we will merge the two states II and IJ. If the first component are matching, and create a new state replacing one of the older states, such as IIJ equal to II union IJ. Then the parsing action are based on each item II. There are three rules. One is rule for the terminals. If we have the production, then we will match the production in this way. A is alpha dot A beta comma B is in II, and go to II comma A is IJ. Then create an entry in the action table, action I comma A equal to shift J. This is for the shift. Then if we have the production like this, A is alpha dot comma A is in II, then in the action table and action I comma A equal to reduce by A is alpha, here A should not be S dash. Third, if production is S dash is S dot comma dollar in II, then action I comma dollar equal to accept. Then fourth is for the variables II comma A equal to IJ, then go to I comma A equal to J. So this is the algorithm for the parsing table, or you can say this is the steps for NALR parsing table. See the example. The same example. S is CC, C is AC, C D. Construct of LR1 for NALR parser. In the previous parser, in the CLR, we solve the same example and we get these canonical set of items. Or you can say these are the set of LR1 parser for the CLR. Now we want to construct the set of items for the NALR parser. In the LALR parser, the first step is to merge these items. If the first is matched with the others, then we can match, then we can merge these two. For example, see the production rule I3, go to I0A. Here also I6, go to I2, A. Now for these, here I3, now see I3 and I6, and the productions are in this way, C A dot C, C dash C A dot C dot this, then C dot AC dot AC. Here this is the reference. Here these are the same. Here these are the same. And C dot D here. So here these items are the same and these are the different. Like this I4 and I7. C D dot. C D dot. This is the same, but the difference is this. So we will merge these two. And C 8 9. Here C AC dot, C AC dot, here this is the difference. So here we will merge I3 and I6, I4 and I7, I5, I8 and I9, like this. Here this is C, this is A dot C, then here dollar. So here dollar, here AD. So here we will write AD and dollar. C dot AC. This is AD dollar. This is C dot D. This is AD dollar. And this is called I3-6, like this. Then this is I7-8. So here I7-8, this is C is D dot A D dot. Then C47. Here this is D dollar, here this is D dollar. So this is matched and this. Next is 89. I89. Here C is A C dot and A D dot. So in this way we can merge these I3 and I6, I4 and I7, I8 and I9, like this. All are same, I0 same, I1 same, I2 same, I3 6 is go to I0A. This is go to I0A. And here C A dot C A dot C A D dollar like this. Then I47 go to I0 comma D. So this is C D dot, Here we merge 4 and 7. So we get this. Like this 8, 9. This is 8, 9. Go to I3, comma C. So this is C, AC dot AD dot. So these are the LR1 items for the LALR parsing. This clear? Then next is, how can we construct the parsing table? Rules are the same. Rules are the same for the construction of the parsing table. Rules are the same for the construction of the parsing table. See, how can we construct these items from this? Here I0 is, we have I0. I0 is S dash dot S dollar S dot CC dollar S dot AC A D and C dot D A D. This is the I0. See, how can we apply this algorithm for the construction of the parsing table? See, first is dot AC A or D. Here we will compare this with this. A is alpha dot A, beta and D. So here A is S, alpha null, A, B, beta, C and B is A, D. So here is II. II means this is I0. Then go to I0, comma A H. So what is I0, comma A? See here, what is I0, comma A? I0, comma A, so that is I3. So that is I36. Here this is I0, comma A, that is I36. So here we will write I36. So here next, create an entry in the action table like this: action 0, comma A is S 36. 0, comma A, that is S 36. Next. Now suppose the second is C dot D. And here A D. Compare with the same A alpha dot A B. So here go to I0, comma D. So that is I0, comma D. So what is I0, comma D? So that is I47. So action 0, comma D is S47. Next for the next production, that is S dot CC, and this is dollar. So here this is the variable. So here what is the rule for this variable? This is the rule for the variable. Here go to I0, C. So what is I0, C? I0, C, that is I2. So here go to 0, C, that is 2. 0, C, that is 2. Next. Now suppose we have the production S dash A. Here this is S dash dot S, and this is dollar. So in this case, this is this action. Action I comma dollar equal to assign. This is in S dash dot S. This is in zero. So this is 1 comma dollar equal to asset. S dot, here S dot in this case, so S dot is S dash is S dot and dollar. This is the production I1. This is the production I1. So 1 comma dollar equal to asset. So 1 comma dollar, so that is equal to asset. See the one more production. Now see the entry in the table like this. Action 0, A, 0 and A, here S36. 0D S47. This is 0D S47. 0D S47. Next, go to 0C, 0C, so that is 2. So that is 2. Next, action $1, action $1, so that is asset. So here this is asset. In this way, we can make the entry in the table for all the items. Now see one rules for the R3, one for the reduce. So these are the for all are for the shift operations. Now see one more example for the reduce. For the reduce, here see the rules for I7. This is for I47. C is I47. So that is go to I0D. Go to I0D. This is I0D. C A D dot A D and dollar. See the algorithm. Here, now compare with this, A is alpha dot and this is A. Here action 4-7, comma, for this A we have these three symbols. So A 47, D 47 dot. This is reduced by A is alpha. So what is the rules? C is D. So this is the rules R3. So in the table, for the symbol A, this is R3, D R3, and this dollar R3. In this way, we can write all the entries in this. We can compute all the entries in this way, and the blank entries are treated as error. See the parsing. See the parsing table. Input buffer, action, go to table, parsing action. Parsing action. The string is AKDD dollar. That string belongs to this grammar. Here, first is action 0, A. See in the table, 0, A. This is S36. So here operation is shift operation, and this is 36. State is 36. So here this is S36. So the operation is shift. Action is shift. Here this is dollar 0. This A is shift to the stack A36. And next is rest of the string is ADD dollar. Next action 36 A. So here 36 A, again this is S36. So operation is shift. Again you can see in the table, this is 36 A. So this is 36. So here we write this 36. Next 0 A 36 A 36. This A is shifted in the stack. Next is D D dollar. Next is action 36 D. So here what is 36D? 36D is shift 47 from the table. Same. Again this is the shift operation. So action is shift. So this is 0A 36, A 36, D 47. Here this is the D dollar. Next is 47 action, 47 D, 47 D, this is 47, this is D, 47 D from the passing table, that is R 36. R 36 means reduce operation. R 3, this is R 3. So this is the reduced operation. So here what is the rules for R3? We have the grammar S C C that is R1, C A C that is R2, C A D that is R3. This is given. So apply this R3, C is reduced by C, D. Here we will reduce this D by C. So here in the go to statement, that is 36, C. Now from the table, 36, D. 36, C, this is 36 and this is C, here this is 89. So we will write this 89 here. So this is 89. Next, dollar 0A36, A36, this D is replaced by C and next is 89. D dollar. What is action? 89D. 89D is 89D is R2. So use the rule R2. This is R2. R2 is C reduced by C AC. See here, this is AC. And here 36, C, so that is 89. Again, dollar 0A36, C 89. Then D dollar. Action 89D. Again R2, same by C AC, this is R2, this is here 0, C, so that is 0 C. So what is 0 C? 0 and this is C, so this is 2. So here we will write the 2. This is true. So dollar 0C2, here D dollar, action 2, D. So here 2, D is S47. So next operation is shift. So shift this D in the stack 0C2D47 and this is dollar. Action 47 dollar, 47 dollar is R3 is reduced by C D. So here this D is replaced by C, so 2 comma C, so that is 2 comma C is 5. 2 comma C is 5, so dollar 0 C 2 C 5. This is dollar 5 comma dollar. So what is $5 from the table? 5 comma dollar, so that is R1. Reduced by SCC. So here this is CC. So now 0 comma S. 0 comma S is 1. So here this is 0 S 1. And here this is dollar 1 comma dollar, so that is accept. So in this way, using the parsing table, we can parse the string. This string, it belongs to this grammar, so this string is accepted. So this is the next, we know that we have three parsers. What is the difference between these parsers? The first is SLR parser is the smallest in size. NALR and CLR have the same size, and CLR and the CLR parser is largest in the size. Then the second comparison, SLR, it is the easiest method based on the follow function. NALR, this method is applicable to wider class than SLR. CLR, this method is most powerful than SLR and NALR. Third, this method exposes less syntactic features than that of LR parser. Most of the syntactic features of a language are expressed in the NALR. This method exposes less syntactic features than that of LR parser. Next is, in SLR parser, error detection is not immediate. In NALR, error detection is not immediate, but in the CLR, immediate error detection is done. Last comparison, it requires less time and space complexity. We know that we measure the complexity in terms of time and space. So in SLR, it requires less time and space complexity. LALR, the time and space complexity is more in LALR as compared to SLR, but efficient method exists in for constructing LALR parser directly. CLR, the time and space complexity is more in CLR. So these are the comparison. Next is conflict in shift reduced grammar. Conflict in shift reduced grammar. We want to take an ambiguous grammar. In the ambiguous grammar, for the symbols, it contains shift and reduce operations both. So here, see the example. Consider a grammar. Consider a grammar E plus E E E into E E E E I. This is the this is the ambiguous grammar, this is the context free grammar, and the grammar is ambiguous. So we want to construct the SLR parsing table for this grammar. So for this grammar, first we, according to this SLR parsing, first we construct the LR1 items. So here I0, I1, I2 we can construct in the previous methods. So we have I0, I1, I2 up to I9 in this way. Now using the set of items, now we want to construct the parsing table. So the second step is to construct the parsing table. For the construction of the parsing table, we know that we have the fourth step. We have the four step in the algorithm for the construction of the parsing table, and the steps are: if we have the roots like this, then we have the rules. First rule is A, we will compare every production with alpha A dot beta and go to I comma A, so that is I J, and here in this case go to action I comma A, so that is R J. Next is A alpha dot, then action I comma A to reduce A alpha, where A belongs to follow of A. Then third is for the grammar, where if the productions are in this way, S dash is S dot, or we can say E dash is E dot. So here in this case, action I comma dollar, so that is a set. Then next is for the variables, go to I comma A is I J, then go to I comma A, so that is. So these are the rules for the SLR parsing table. Next, we can apply all these rules, and we can construct the parsing table in this way. So first see, this I dash in E dot, this is in I1, E dash is E dot. So what is the means of this E dot? E dash is E dot. Here this rule is this. So action I comma I means 1 comma dollar, so that is equal to asset. That is asset. So in the parsing table, this is the parsing table, 1 dollar, so that is asset. Next, for this 0, for this, now suppose we have the production like this, E A dot ID, compare with A is alpha dot A beta, then go to I0 comma ID, so I0 comma ID is I0 ID is I3, then action 3 comma 0 comma 3 0 comma id is S3. 0 id is S3. Shift 3. So this is 0 id is shift 3. 0 id is S3. In this way, we can construct all. I want to say, I want to explain this. This 7, how we get S4 and R1, both the entries in the same, for the same symbol. See the rule I7. This I7 is this E. E plus E dot compare with A alpha dot. This is in this alpha dot we compute the follow of E. So here A equal to E, alpha is E plus E. So here we will compute the follow of E. So follow of E. So what is the follow of E? E follow, so that is the plus multiply follow of E this and follow of E, so that is id. E is the starting symbol, E is the starting symbol, so add the dollar. So these are the follow of E. For all the symbols we will write the rules. This action for this 7 comma for the symbol A plus, so that is this rule, this rule, so that is A alpha. So this rule is this. So E dot I4 comma E. So here the rule is R1. So this is for the plus. What is the rule for the plus? This is R1, R2, R3 and this is R4. So this is the rule 1 for the plus. So this is R1. Action 7 multiply this is R1. Action 7, this is R1 and action 7 dollar, this is R1. So now see in the table here for the 7 plus R1 multiply R1, this symbol R1 and the dollar is R1. Then how we get this S4? In the 7, now select the second rule. E is E plus E dot plus E. Compare with A alpha dot A beta. A E alpha E A dot A is plus beta is E. So here, so what is this? Go to I7 comma this plus. So what is I7 plus this plus? That is I7 plus this, so that is plus for this plus this, so that is I4. So action 7 comma plus is S4. For like for this rule, action 7 multiply, so that is for this multiply This is I5. So that is S5. So we get for this cell 1, this is S4 and this is S5. S4 and this is S5. In this way, we have both the operations for the same symbol S7, S4 and R1, shift and reduce operation. Like this. So this is the complete table. In this way, we can construct the complete table. Next, parsing the string. In this case, this is the input and this is the stack. See the conflict. Start with the initial symbol. Then string, it belongs to this grammar. So 0 ID. For this 0 ID, the operation is shift operation. So we perform the shift operation in this way. Stack, input buffer, passing, action table, go to table, and the parsing action stack id plus id multiply id dot. Same the parsing. First symbol is 0, so 0 comma id. So what is 0 ID? So that is 0 ID, 0 and this ID, so that is S3. So here this is S3. Perform the shift operation and we get $0 ID 3. Then this is plus ID multiply ID dollar. Action, this is 3 comma plus. So what is 3 plus? And 3 plus is R4. So that is the reduce. Rule number 4, that is E is ID. Used by E is ID. Then here this is 0 comma E. So 0 comma E, so that is 1. And in this way we can pass the string. Now see the conflict. Where we get the conflict? We can part the string in this way. Now the conflict here. For this, now the symbol is 7 multiply. For the 7 multiply from the table, here for the 7 and this symbol multiply, we have shift S5 or R1. Now we can perform the shift operation and we can perform the reduce operation. Now which operation we have to perform? So here in this case we will see the precedence of the operators. Here we will see the precedence of the operator in this way. Here the next operator is this multiply. Here the stack operator is plus. This operator has the higher precedence than this, So we will perform the shift operation. So here we use the shift operation and pass completely and the string is accepted. And see the next conflict. If the grammar is like this, if the string is like this, for the same example, if the string is like this and we pass the string, again see the conflict here. Here this is multiplier and this is plus. And for this e, 8 and plus, for the 8 and plus from the table, for the 8 and this plus, we have S4 and R2, both the operation. Now which operation we have to perform? So again see the precedence of the operator plus and this multiplier. This plus has the less precedence as compared to the multiplier, so we have to perform the reduce operation. So here we will perform the reduce operation and we can solve this and we get the accepting strings, and the procedure is same. Now we can modify the previous parsing table, and we can modify. Now we get the modified parsing table in this view. Here we perform the shift operation, so here we use the shift. Here we use the reduce operation, here we make the entry for the reduce operation. Now this parsing table is modified. If the grammar is ambiguous, then we get the problem like this, and we can solve the problem in this way. So these are the conflict in shift reduce parsing. Another conflict is using the dangling as ambiguity. What is the means of this dangling as ambiguity? Now suppose the grammar is this. Consider the grammar is S I S E S S I S S A. If the grammar is this, then now we can construct the canonical set of items. We know what is the way, and then we can construct the parsing table. Using the canonical set of items, we can construct the parsing table. If we construct the parsing table, again we will get S5 or R2, shift and reduce operation. Now which operation we will perform? For this case, again we will pass the string. Here this string is belongs to this grammar. This string is belongs to this grammar. Again we will solve the again we will pass the string using the parsing table. The method is same. Now see the conflict where the conflict exists. Here 4e. If we get 4e, then we get the conflict. Here 4e. 4e, then we get the conflict. We will perform the shift operation or we will perform the reduce operation. Now suppose if we try using the reduce operation. So here we are using the reduce operation. 4e, so that is the R2. R2 means the second rule. So here reduced by this R2, and finally we have 1, and here we have the symbol. If we have 1 and this symbol, then it will give and it will give the error. 1a, for this 1a, for this 1a, for this 1a, here we have the error. All the blank entries are errors. So here for this 1a, so that is the error. Next, here this is the same string. Now again this is 4e. Now which operation we have to perform? Now, in the previous case, we use this. Here we perform the reduce operation. Now we will try using the shift operation. So here we perform the shift operation. If we perform the shift operation, then this string is accepted. So this is the dangling as problem. So we can modify this parsing table in this way. Here we are using in the previous table we are using shift and reduce, but if we use the reduce, then we will not get the accepting states. But if we use the shift, then we get the accepting states. So we modify the table in this way. So in this way, if these are the shift reduce conflict and reference the same textbooks and the reference book and